So here we are ranking the 2021 F1 drivers. These are just my personal opinions, don't take them too seriously. If you have any different ones, let me know in the comments. So to explain the tier list here a bit, D is pretty bad, underperforming the car. Maybe it's rookies which aren't really familiar with the car, but not doing as good as they could. C is performing a bit better, maybe having something to prove, being a bit of at risk for next year. B is being a solid midfield driver, A is being really good, overperforming the car, and S is just basically God tier, nothing better than this. So let's start with Fernando Alonso. So Alonso hasn't had maybe the season he wanted in terms of placements, but he's just such a great driver. He's so consistent, he gets the most out of the car at all times. As we've seen in the sprint race at Silverstone, he still is the king of starts when he wants. He can gain a lot of places and overperforming the car, of course. And in terms of placements, he's 11th in the standings, while his teammate is 2 places behind. He has 12 more points than his teammate, so I think he can go straight to A. So then, Yuki Tsunoda. There was a lot of hype for this rookie at the start of the season. He hasn't really matched this hype. He got a good placement in the first race, but later on he went on to make a lot of mistakes, especially in qualifying, pushing the car too much in Imola, in France, in Baku. Braking too late, turning too aggressively, especially in qualifying, making some mistakes. And while I think he's pretty harsh with himself, he really blames the car a lot, especially in Spain. He said, "I can't believe Pierre Gasly has my same car," and really complaining a lot to his engineer. I think he's matured a bit. He doesn't really blame the car as much as he did before. He realized he still has to get a bit of familiarity with it, but still not doing as good as he could with that car, so I think it's a C. Kimi is difficult. He has 1 point, just as much as Antonio, his teammate. I think he is 15th in the standings. His teammate is considered behind just for the placement, but in terms of points is the same. Kimi has had quite an interesting season. Again, not the best one. Like, he's made some mistakes that are really weird. Like in Portimao, he hit Antonio in the straight. Just, it's like he wasn't even looking at him. In Austria, he did the same with Vettel. Like, just like he wasn't looking. Those are really bad mistakes, dumb mistakes. So, while I think he's a great driver, this year he isn't really showing too much of that. So I really can't put him in B. He has to go to C for now. Maybe he will get better in the rest of the season, I hope so. But now he's just at the same level of Antonio, pretty much. So, in fact, Antonio. Again, Antonio is 16th in the standings. He has 1 point, just like Kimi. And in terms of race pace, it's not really the best. But he really is good in the first lap of the race. What he doesn't match in qualifying, he gets in the first lap of the race. He always gains a lot of places. I think in Monaco, he was one of the few drivers to actually make an overtake in the first place, and it was very good. So I can't really put him in B because he's not really that better than Kimi, but I'm going to put him with him. So Sebastian's really hard. I'm actually a supporter of Sebastian, but this season there's been a lot of highs and lows. For example, sometimes not making it out of Q1, sometimes even finishing on the podium, sometimes getting beaten by Lance, sometimes beating Lance. But on average, he's, I think, in the middle, because when he has a great car, like in Baku, he shows he can fight, but when the car is not so good, we can't really judge. For example, in Bahrain, the car was really bad at the beginning of the season, but still he made a mistake. I remember going into the back of Ocon in braking. So even when the car is not good, we can't only blame the car. So on average, I still think he deserves B. If he has more races like Baku, I may put him in A, but he's definitely not going to be lower than B for now. Then George Russell, I think George is not that difficult. He goes straight to A, overperforming the car. It's just, I mean, beating his teammate is not really difficult because his teammate, you're going to see where he ends up in the tier list, but he's still making the most out of the car, getting in Q3 a Williams. Even though the race pace is really lacking because of the car, but he really fights a lot. For example, in Austria, you can see, actually Styria, sorry, it was the Styrian Grand Prix, you can see how he fought with Fernando. Fernando has a lot of respect for him. Rumors are that he's going to go to Mercedes. I actually made a video about it, go watch it if you haven't already. But I think as of now, he's world championship material. I'm not going to put him in S because we haven't really seen what he's capable of with a good car, even though we've seen in Sakhir, but that was 2020. So, but I think next year, if he goes in a Mercedes, I can definitely put him in an S, but definitely now he's not going lower than A. Now, while I think Lewis is an excellent driver, I don't think this year he's really had the occasion to prove it. I mean, if we go through the races, in Bahrain, he took pole, he had the fastest car, but then was overtaken by Verstappen and only won because Verstappen had gone over the track limits, even though Lewis had gone over the track limits for like 60 laps. Then in Imola, he was overtaking at the start, made a mistake later on, and was really lucky to get the easy second place because of a red flag just after his crash. And later in Portimão in Spain, he really just had the superior car. In Monaco, it wasn't easy to overtake. He qualified 7th because Leclerc brought out the red flag. Baku, he had the chance to win. He threw it away by making a mistake, not pressing a button when he shouldn't. And Austria and Styria, he really didn't have the best car. He also had damage in Styria. It was his fault, but he still had damage. He couldn't really fight. In France, Verstappen's car in the last two laps was just miles quicker than his, but he didn't even try defending. And lastly, in the British GP, it was just a very easy win. Like, he was so much faster than Leclerc, the car was so much faster. So, as of now, I haven't really seen him fight that much for this title. Like, yeah, in Britain he was being aggressive, but we know where that led to. You can see my two videos of the analysis. So I want to see them going wheel to wheel again, and if Lewis comes out on top, being clean, I think I can put him in S. But as of now, I can only put him in A really. Like, I believe he's S material, but this season I think it's been an A. Now, Mick Schumacher and Nikita Mazepin, let's put them together here. While I think Mick is better than Nikita, in fact, I wanted to do like a D plus list and D minus and put Mick in the D plus and Nikita in the D minus. I don't have those here, D plus and D minus. And so if I have to put them in D, I still think Mick is a bit better because even though they've both made a lot of mistakes, a lot of mistakes that could have been avoided, I think Mick has done a bit less and he's been a bit more consistent, while Nikita has done a lot of spins, but he's really not that far from his teammate. Apart from the memes and everything, he's really not been death of his teammate. In fact, some races he's gotten ahead of his teammate. He has a better race pace sometimes. In Silverstone, after the spin, he made a great overtake. So I think Mick is D plus, Nikita is D minus, but I can only put them in D for now. Now, Max Verstappen, let's look back at the season. Bahrain, he qualified second, he didn't really have the best car, but he somehow managed to almost win the race, coming just at 7 tenths from Lewis, having actually overtaken him, but he had to give back the position because of track limits, as I said. Then in the next races, Imola, he started third, got into first place, sorry, after turn one with a great start. Spain, he also got ahead, but then Mercedes was just so much quicker. Portimao, I actually inverted Portimao in Spain, but whatever. Portimao is basically the same, he got ahead, but then again he was overtaken, so he's making great starts. Imola, Portimao, Spain, incredible starts. Baku, he was easily winning if he hadn't had the tire failure. Monaco, he won, he didn't get in pole position, but again Leclerc had caused the red flag, so we don't really know who would have gotten pole position. Then France, he made a bad start, but with the strategy he was then able to win. And later in Austria and Styria, he just had the better car. And in the British GP, in the sprint, he was able to go from second place to first. In the race, he was able to defend very well against a clearly faster car, until the crash, of course. So I think he just has to go straight to A. Now, I know I'll get insults from Hamilton fans, but this is just my opinion. It's just about this season, so whatever. Nicolas Latifi, great person, not that great of a driver, unfortunately. He hasn't really made a lot of mistakes, except for Imola when he crashed with Mazepin, a very big crash actually. But yeah, I don't know if he's underperforming the car, but he definitely isn't overperforming it like George is doing. He's actually behind Mick in the standing, so it's just a D for me. Lando is just going straight up here. Lando, now I know I'll have people say, how can you put Lando on top of Lewis? Again, it's about the season, and this season he's just been god tier. He's just been so good. He's had so many good placements. I think actually in Imola he had gotten second place, but it was deleted by track limits. Then Austria, even though he was helped by Verstappen's slipstream, he got second place again. In the race, he doesn't defend much, especially against Hamilton in Austria and in the British Grand Prix. He almost lets faster cars pass, but still his qualifying performance, his race pace, his awareness, his racecraft, he's just been so good this year, so consistent, consistently destroying Ricciardo even at Monaco, lapping him. That's just crazy. A driver like Ricciardo lapping him, that's just crazy. I think he really deserves being there. Valtteri Bottas, it's not been his greatest year, is it? He's really not having the best season at Mercedes. I think the team is not really supporting him. Like for example, when in Monaco, he was blamed by Toto for not making a good stop, which ended with him retiring from the race. I think not having that support when it clearly wasn't your mistake, like even if it was his mistake, a good team doesn't really blame you for that. I think it's really impacted him. You could see in France he was really angry. They don't listen to him anymore. They just want him to be a wingman to let Lewis pass when Lewis is behind him. He really isn't having that good of a season. Even in Imola, I think he was out of the top 10. He was being overtaken by Russell while his teammate managed to go to P2 from P7. I'll put him in B because I think it's better than Yuki Tsunoda, Kimi and Antonio this season, but he doesn't really match A performance as of now. Now, Charles Leclerc, again, not the best car this season. Ferrari doesn't have the best car, but still better than last year, and he's been able to fight. And while the pole positions in both Monaco and Baku were pretty lucky due to red flags, I think he's overperforming the car. Like in the British GP, he couldn't do anything more than he did. Like keeping Hamilton behind for that long, that was just insane with a Ferrari that is basically a midfield team now. Not really a midfield, but not even best of the rest, to be honest. So I think he deserves A. He's made some mistakes this year, actually, a lot of mistakes, a lot of crashes, but his performance is still really good. I think he deserves to be there. Checo is another driver who's had a lot of highs and lows. Like at the start of the season, it was pretty good start, and even in Imola, he managed to out-qualify his teammate, but then got overtaken, and the race wasn't really that good. In Baku, he managed to keep the Mercedes back, which was titanic, I think. He also got a really slow pit stop, but managed to win the race. He won because, of course, Max had a puncture, but still an impressive performance there. While some other races, like the whole Britain weekend, really bad. I think he qualified P5, which wasn't that bad, but then in the race he spun. The day later he started from the pit lane, he tried to make up places. He was like P10, I think, I'm not sure, but then they made him pit to get the fastest lap, something they wouldn't have made him do if he was like in P4, P3, which with all the retirements there he could have easily achieved if he hadn't spun the day before. So a lot of highs and lows, but average, I think it's B. He can definitely go to A if he gets better, just like Lewis will go to S if he proves what he's capable of, if he has the occasion. Daniel's been a bit disappointing this year, I think. He really isn't familiar with the car. Somebody said he's a late breaker, he likes to brake late, that's like his signature in Formula One. I mean, his quote, sometimes you just have to lick the stamp and send it. That's what he likes to do, and they said this car doesn't reward him for doing that, it actually punishes him. But still, after like 9 or 10 races, I don't actually remember. You should get a bit familiar with the car, with the simulator, with all you have. I think he's doing that. He's doing better in Austria and Britain. Britain, he had a really good result, really solid result. He's improving. But other than that, all the other races weren't really. He wasn't really on par with his teammate. He was actually lapped in Monaco. He was constantly being beaten. He still has to improve in qualifying, but now race pace is getting better. I think by the end of the season he could be between B and A if he keeps improving, but as of now he's between C and B. As of now C, but I have faith I can put him in B at the end of the year. Carlitos Sainz, I think he is a really talented driver. He has had a pretty good season. He's 12 points behind Charles Leclerc. But still a solid season, still he's proving what he's capable of. I think if he improves a bit his qualifying performance, he could definitely be on par with Charles. But as of now, he qualifies a bit further in the back than Charles, so he struggles while having traffic. While when the track is clear, he really is as fast as Charles in the race. So again, I believe he can go to A, but as of now I'm going to put him into B. If he improves a bit in qualifying and makes a bit less mistakes in the races. He's done a bit at the beginning of the season, he's making less now. He can really go to A. Ocon, nice start of the season. I think he's really gotten a bit worse now with the placement. It's like after they told him he would be racing with Alpine until 2023, he's starting to relax a bit. Like in Austria, I think he qualified P17 with an Alpine, which wasn't really the best car, of course, but he could have done much better. In the second weekend, Alonso said they had the pace to do P5 or P6. He got nowhere near that. Then, of course, he was taken out at the beginning of the race. He got sandwiched. But good start of the season. Now a bit less. He's doing a bit worse. He has to get back to the pace he had in the beginning of the season. As of now, he has something to prove. So I'm going to put him in C. Basically, all the people you see in C have something to prove for me. Then on to Pierre Gasly, the man who's faster in an AlphaTauri than in a Red Bull. I think he really is familiar with the car, he really likes the car, he gets a lot out of it. He's having good placements, a bit of an unlucky weekend in Austria and Styria, really not the best weekend. He's not had a lot of luck in some races, but in others he's done good. In Baku, I think he even got on the podium, I think. Did he? Let me check. Yeah, he did. Again, Verstappen and Hamilton were out of the games, but still an impressive performance. I'm going to put him at B for now, but if he gets more podiums or a race like Monza last year, I think he actually has the potential to go to A, in my opinion. I'll actually move Lewis to the left so people don't get mad. I don't know why people think the guy to the left is better. I just put it randomly, but I'm going to put it to the left so people get a bit less mad. They are going to get mad anyway that I put him in A, but if you consider the results, I think it's fair. Again, I don't think he belongs in A. Just this tier is about the season he's having. I don't think he's an A driver. I think he's had an A season. So if he manages to show what he's capable of, I'm sure he will go to S easily, no problem. Then Lance, he has something to prove. He's doing good. His dad said he's like Vettel, he's matching Vettel's performance. I don't think that's necessarily true, but he has showed in the recent years that he's not just a paid driver. He has the skill to be in Formula One. So if he gets some good weekends like he did in the beginning of the season and keeps beating Vettel, he will definitely go to B. He's so close to being at B, but again, he needs to prove something to me. So that's my tier list. Let me look at it again. I don't think I would really change anything. Yeah, it's really dependent on the next races. I think at the end of the year I'll make a part 2 and it will be a bit different. Some drivers will be more at the top if they prove what they are capable of. Some drivers might go a bit lower if they don't prove what I thought as of now. So yeah, let me know in the comments what your top 5, top 10, top 20 is. If you agree, be respectful, please. I know you're going to be mad about Lewis if you're a Lewis fan, but be respectful, please. So thank you. If you enjoyed the video, leave a like, please subscribe and hit the bell. See you in the next one.